So far, we've encountered types inhabited by numbers, functions, paths, even types themselves. However, in this video, we are going to use types in a very special way. This will allow us to reconstruct logic itself. We are going to treat types as propositions. And in some sense, we've already been doing this with equality types. For example, in the same way that the inhabitants of the equality type x equals y are proofs that x is equal to y, the inhabitants of the proposition p are proofs that p is true. Note that unlike in classical logic, where we either know that a proposition is true or we don't know a proposition is true, in type theory we could have multiple inhabitants proving that a proposition is true. So, to prove that a proposition is true, we need to construct a term thereof. But how do we prove that a proposition is false? Well, type theorists say that a proposition is false if we can construct a function from the proposition to the empty type. And yes, as the name suggests, an empty type is a type without inhabitants. But why would we define the falsehood of a proposition like this? Well, suppose we did have a function that maps every term in the proposition to a term in the empty type. The question that immediately arises is, to which terms could it possibly map? Thus, such a function could only be defined if there were no terms in the proposition to map in the first place. The proposition must then be uninhabited. And the analog of this in classical logic is not P. Note that we use this little symbol to indicate that a proposition is not true. In logic, this is called negation. Actually, functions serve a much more general purpose when we treat types as propositions. A function from P to Q simply means that whenever we have a term in P, we can construct a term in Q. And logically, this means that P implies Q. We now know how to construct proofs, negations, and implications in type theory. Thanks for watching.